What is going on, everyone? My name's Boyt, and I'm back with some more Age of Mythology. The Titans action. Spawning in the red color, playing as Hades. His name is Nullus. He gets his mane, ladies and gentlemen. His opponent today, no slouch on this god either, playing as Thor in the blue color. His name is Yoshi. Game number four. A solid series thus far. These guys meet each other in the later stages of Age of Mythology tournaments all the time because they're just that good. And they're going to have to duke it out here yet again. I'm not 100% sure what their head-to-head record in tournament actually is. But they do play each other quite a bit. Anyways, nonetheless, let's see what's going to happen. Yoshi gets his Thor. Thor versus Hades here. I'm excited. I love this matchup. People are always telling me, Thor, no good. I'm telling people, you know, Thor, good. You just have to be good. Like, there was this time, let's go back in time. I want a bit of a history lesson here about Thor. There was a guy way back when called MMC Starsky. If you guys haven't heard of him, a Thor player in the early stages of Age of Mythology's life. Back when Bolt on Ulfsark was a thing. Back when Shifting Sands stole 3 villagers and an ox cart. You heard me? 3 villagers and an ox cart you could grab with Shifting Sands. Back when Bolt one-hitted Nidhogg. Now that's not Thor, but one-hitted Nidhogg. Back when villagers could town Bell out of Frost. And he was showing everyone that Thor very strong. And why was Thor strong? Not because Thor is inherently strong, but because at a high level, when you play this god at a really high level, he becomes one of the best gods. And there's lots of reasons behind it. One, he's got the best late game out of the Norse gods because the dwarven armory aspect, having that extra tier of upgrades. Neither here nor there, but he does have that. And two, he's just got a whole bunch of tools in his arsenal that allow him to get victories, stay alive. And it's just tough to make it work, though, for a lot of players because it is you have to be really, really good at defense with Norse. And defending with Norse is tough as opposed to defending with Hades, which is easy. So that's the big thing. Not that defending is actually quite difficult in general in RTS games, but and that's why the top players are so good at it. Because they've worked on it so much. But nonetheless, that's the history lesson over. MNC Starsky, really, really good player. There was another guy way back when. I'm pretty sure he played Thor as well. His name was Nature Phoenix. He had a bit of a weird style where he would kill off his own economy more. But he would like stop training villagers quite a bit in order to spend more on army. And he would just be using that army to raid his opponents. So while he wasn't really getting in front, he wasn't falling behind. It was a weird, he had a great style. It was fun to watch, fun to learn from. Anyways, nonetheless, relics on the map. We have the Ring of Nimbulung over here with the 18 free gold per minute there, as well as the Fetters of Fenrir. Now everyone can have a 250% or plus villager pierce damage. As Nullus unfortunately looks like he hasn't quite scouted his second hunt here, but he has advanced. He's got a little bit of food left in this boar, and he may be thinking that this map has not got any hunt on it. Wait, let's check out what Nullus has actually spotted here. He hasn't spotted the hunt at all here in this game. Let's take a look over here. There, it's over here. You hate to see it. Nullus, you hate to see it. He might go for this town center and he might be granted vision of this hunt and he might be okay here, but this is a sad state of affairs nonetheless. But Fetters of Fenrir is picked up as the Duskboss searching around and Nullus is definitely going to be going for this town center play, but I've said it once, I'll say it a million times. Going second town center against Norse puts the game in the Norse player's hands. And what I mean by that is, if the Norse player plays this one correctly, there is no reason he can't find a win. He should be able to find a win. in most games against the second town center. Now, some games when it's like really, really closed off map and there's gold mines behind everything that's closed off, then sure, two town center Greek is going to work. But on a map like this, nice and open, two town center can be a little bit challenging. But Nullis is going for the bottom town center, so at the very least, he's going to be able to spot this hunt that's here, potentially, once he clicks the upgrade, that the sentinel's on this position. Forest fire down. Standard. Ulfsark getting pushed back. Longhouse is coming down here for Yoshi. As the dwarves coming through here, and the Kadoskobos scouting around, has Nullis spotted it? He has spotted that hunt, so he might be a little bit kicking himself about his decision here. As the Chiron comes in, the Chiron says, no Valkyrie, not today. And he takes so much damage here. One thing that I've always thought was a bit funky about the change that happened with the extra track rating that came in onto the classical age archer heroes, I think it's necessary, but I think that the problem that happened with that was in the same moment, I believe, I could be wrong about the history here, I believe the Chiron got moved up to 5.5 speed from 5.3, where at 5.3 speed, at least then the Valkyrie and all of the speedy myth units at 5.5 speed can kind of retreat away. The Sphinx can't, but at least the Valkyrie can, and then this feels like a little bit better, but then again, whatever. No one cares. So we do see the Raiding Cavalry going to be trying to hit a bit of a raid here. One villager. Oh, not going to get that one down. Going to be retreating away. This guy's such low HP. Can he snipe him? It's not going to happen. The villager's retreating away. And Nullis here. Does he know about it? He still doesn't know about it. Obviously, the hunt's got to be somewhere. He knows that it's somewhere, but he hasn't seen it just yet. As the Chiron retreating away here. Still trying to hit some raids on this position as the Minotaur going to push through. Minotaur on these villages does so much damage here. As the village is going to be retreating away. I love this here from Yoshi. He's just like, I don't care about this Ajax. Let me just kill off the Chiron. The Chiron's trying to get some damage done, but this Minotaur's not doing a whole bunch. And the Ford Town Center are going to be coming up here for Yoshi. Kind of a little bit in secret, because the back over here with the Kadoskobos checking out this Town Center. Not only that, he's given away that it's here by targeting down the house. So Yoshi can pretty safely just get this Town Center up while still raiding. Farms coming down here as well for Nullis, as he still hasn't spotted that hunt here. But the defense is in full swing. And we'll see if he can hold on. The problem most of the time with these two town center players ends up either being on the second gold mine or in the mythic age, once the Norse player hits that mythic age timing. We'll see how things go. But the boom in full swing. Villagers in the main base. Lots of cows here for both players, mind you, as they've both got their husbandry in. Watchtowers is up for Nullis, pulled off of this location. Completely fine over there. He's got a really safe wood line over here. But great snipe there on that villager as Yoshi pushes in there. Still, wait, has he got sentinels up in his main base? Still no sentinels getting thrown down, which is a bit confusing. Definitely utilize that one. There's a Raiding Cavalry going to be pulling back. Ajax over here going to town on these Raiding Cavalry. It's a difficult fight to take. And Yoshi does pull away. Now, Yoshi, does he have the Valkyrie? Yes, he does, as the Chiron is now out. Will he be able to win this fight? I mean, the Chiron's not paying attention over here. There we go. Valkyrie, Tango down! As Nullis gets Hand Axe, Pickaxe, Plow. Military Academy coming up. And this is complete standard here for Nullis, as he's finally spotted these deer over here. The question is, will he just go over and eat them or not? I mean, he's already got the farms. They're really safe and easy to eat there, but do you get them or not? Yoshi going up to a third town center, still raiding, still looking for villager kills. Another Valkyrie is out. Villagers getting pulled off of this wood line here. Can you jump into the town center or sit out of the town centre if they want, just for a hot minute. As medium Raiders comes through for Yoshi. Look at this Minotaur, though. 1-2 Dwarves getting taken out. He's going to continue to get pressure done. Where's the Herso? One Herso gets queued up over here from Yoshi to go over and deal with this, as that Ox card is now under pressure. And what is Nullis doing? He's got all of these upgrades, all the baseline upgrades here. Farms still coming down. A wall up over here will mean this hunt is going to be open to eating here. That's the dwarves. Get the Herser out. The Herser is here. The Minotaur is snared. Where's the Herser going? Henrik Kettlemocker. Imagine having the name Kettlemocker. And in fact, actually more so, imagine going into someone's house and mocking their kettle. I don't know what I'm saying. 8 HP remaining on the Minotaur as it does end up getting sniped down. Dead. All is sorted. Raiders still killing villagers up on this position as Nullis is now trying to grab this hunt in the corner. As the Ajax is going to come over here. Is there enough units here to defend this? There is a potential for a restoration, though, I think. Against Norse, you really want to save it for Frost. But we do see Nullis dropping that restoration, and Yoshi, he's going to get out of there. And Yoshi knows how... Bragi. Bragi is a pickable god for Thor. Now, we don't see it ever because Skadi is just better in every single way. But Yoshi here up 2-1 in classic Thor fashion, in classic Norse fashion. He is going to be doing his best impression of a Thor player attempting to throw this game. Yoshi's 3 towns and he's got to the heroic age. He's got everything he needs here to have success in this game, but he's picked Bragi. Now, I'm not saying that he's gonna throw the game, but he's... There's actually a pretty famous game. Not a famous game. Infamous game. It's famous to me. I hold it dear in my heart. And it's Chemo versus Shelty, Champions League Season 1, semi-finals. 2-2 on the map Mirage. I think it was the final game in their best of 5. And this was that free choice when we were doing free choice in the Champions League. And these guys had been putting a lot of effort in. And Shelty was playing Thor for the entirety of that series. As we see Yoshi dropping the flaming weapons. This is early, but the village is getting pushed off the gold mine. And actually, Nullis can just pull back and be really, really safe here. But the Freighter's in this position, getting a good amount of damage here. Anyways. Shelty went Bragi, ended up losing the game with a crazy timing attack with the flaming weapons, because that's what flaming weapons makes you do. And he ended up losing that series 3-2, where he could have won it the other way around. Anyways, Yoshi now pushing through, getting good damage done. He's opened up this location. We do see the villagers sneaking this gold mine in classic Hades fashion. Also, walls coming up over here to grab this gold mine as well. As great defensive position here for Nullis. As the Raiders are still trying to push through, we do see a hill fort coming up during this flaming weapons to get set up for. Are you really lost? Nullis, 13 minutes in. He's a little bit behind on villagers. He has been spotted on this position. This one's almost walled in. Life's tough. But he does tap out and Yoshi gets the dub. He wins in 4, ladies and gentlemen. This is a surprise to me. Yoshi getting the dub with Thor against Nullis' Hades. He's got to be feeling good about that one. I mean, solid gameplay. Gets the 3 town centers. The problem here for Nullis was he saw the hunt too late. It's competitive mega random. You don't know how much hunt is. You have to scout the entire map. I don't care how much you think you understand competitive Mega Random. You don't understand it. You need to get every bit of the map scouted to ensure that you know what's on the map. And that's of your own side. You could either do that or scout the entirety of your opponent's map. And that way you know what's on your side. But I guess the fact that he missed this hunt early means he didn't really know the best way to approach this. And he ends up being just really, really far behind in this game and just not wanting to be under the pump for the entirety of the game, which is kind of what was going to happen. Stuck in the classical age, going to have to be get greeted by Huskarl throwing Axeman, which is basically an impossible to kill composition until you have a pass pissed. Plus he's getting raided all over the place and he can't get a gold mine. Life is going to be really tough. So I understand the tap out. It's valid. He's given a lot of credit to Yoshi that Yoshi's going to play this one out at a super high level, and Yoshi has been playing this series at a super high level the entire time. If you guys enjoyed this one, please consider hitting the follow on the Twitch. If you're on the YouTube, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next game.